Hello everyone, my name is Ashveer Singh and today we are going to discuss one another topic, that is automotive sensor. This lecture is the part one of this portion and we are covering few topics of this chapter. So let's begin. So in today's presentation we are going to cover these three topics, that basic principle of sensors, main requirement of sensors and type of automotive sensors. So what are the basic principle of sensors? The sensors are used to convert the physical or chemical quantity into electrical quantity. So whatever in ancient vehicles, or we can say in previous vehicles, earlier ages of developing the vehicles, we are using the analog system. Now we are using the digital system, so that we can easily monitor the condition of the vehicle. So in that case, with the help of networking system that we have already discussed in previous lecture, we are using the another component, that is sensors. So sensors generally used in electrical or electronic system. So this is the part of electronic part of automotive system. Then the sensors and actuator form an interface between the vehicle and its complex drive, braking, chassis, suspension and body components. So individual system like drive system, braking system, chassis system, suspension system has some predefined sensors and actuators accompanied with each other to work in a single interface and developing a system for gathering the information and to compute through the use of ECU. The main requirement of sensors are the degree of stresses that which the sensor is subjected is determined by the operating conditions, whether it is mechanical, whether it is chemical or optical or electronics. So what kind of conditions, operating conditions will be there, that is already defined by the user while using a particular type of sensors. Then as per the application and technical requirement, automotive sensors are assigned on the basis of three reliability case. So every sensor is defined in three categories or in three cases. So there are few systems which are fallen into these cases. First is steering, braking and passenger protection sensors, then engine, drivetrain, suspension and tire sensors, and comfort. Then third case is comfort, convenience, information, diagnosis and theft determination sensors. One of the most important requirement for the sensors, to use sensors in the automotive, is that the miniature concepts are involved, employed to achieve compact unit dimension. So we try to reduce the size of the sensor as small as possible. So the next topic is the type of automotive sensors. So in this presentation we are going to discuss these sensors, which is position sensors, speed and RPM sensor, acceleration and vibration sensor, pressure sensor, flow sensor, gas sensor and concentration sensors. So first one is the position sensor. What is the purpose of position sensor? It records one or multi-dimensional displacement and angular position, that is maybe translational or rotatory variable. So it define the distance and the angular rotation. So it also counts the RPM also. So the variables which can be identify or measured with the help of position sensors are divided into two categories. First is directly measured variables and second one is indirectly measured variables. So five types of variables are directly measured. First is throttle valve position, then next is accelerator pedal position, then seat and mirror position, control rack and travel position, and long and short distance distances. So these are the direct variables. Then next is indirect variables, which are sensor plate deflection sensor, that will define the flow rate of any fluid, or generally in the air flow air fuel ratio. Then next is deflection of a spring mass system that will define the acceleration, and third one is torsional angle, so that will define the torque of the crankshaft which is developed by the engine. So by using the position sensor, we can measure some of the direct variables and some of the indirect variables. The next one is speed and RPM sensor. So speed and RPM sensor, as names referred, it measured the number of revolution or distance traveled per unit time. So what are the revolution in 1 minute and what is the distance traveled by the system, by the vehicle in 1 minute. It helps to monitor the stability of the vehicle at a particular speed. So if the system is designed for a particular speed and the stability of the vehicle depends on that speed, we have to monitor the particular speed of the vehicle, critical speed of the vehicle. It also helps to decide the fuel injection rate according to the speed of the vehicle. If we are increasing the speed, then it will always increase to increase the revolution of the engine. As per the increment in the revolution of the engine, we have to increase the fuel supply. So in that case, the fuel is to be supplied more. Then used to find the relative rotating velocity of crankshaft, camshaft and the wheel speed. So at what RPM, what is the relative velocity of crankshaft and camshaft, so that we have to identify the critical velocity of camshaft as well as the crankshaft. Next one is the acceleration and vibration sensor. So these are generally used in very high-tech vehicles. So all acceleration sensor and sensor measure the principle of the force exerted on the mass by accelerating according to fundamental Newton's law of motion. So in that case, the sensors are used for the passenger protection, triggering of the passenger protection system like airbags, seat belts, tightening and roller bars. Also helps to knock control in the internal combustion engine. As we are suddenly increasing the acceleration, the fuel supply has to be increases. In that case, we have to measure the rate of change of acceleration. To detect the lateral acceleration rate and velocity change in forward vehicle, four-wheel drive fitted with ABS. So what is the reduction rate of acceleration, that we called as a deceleration rate, and what is the acceleration rate so that the ABS can cope up with the speed of the vehicle to make the vehicle stable by reducing the range of acceleration in particular period of time. The next is pressure sensor. The pressure sensor variables are the measured variables are non directional force acting in the direction, all the direction which occur in gases and liquids. So these type of sensors are used the pressure inside the fluid basically which are flowing into the automotive system. Dynamic and static acting sensors are used here for the measurement of the pressure. If the pressure is changing and we are interested to find out the force related to that pressure, we use the dynamic and dynamic sensor. If we are interested to find out the static change in the location of the displacement of the particular component, that is the diaphragm, with the help of the pressure, so we find out, we can use the static sensors. Okay, so the measured variables are intake manifold pressure. Intake manifold pressure is used to identify the pressure of air charged which is taking into the combustion chamber through the intake manifold. Then hydraulic reservoir pressure, if there is any hydraulic system used in the vehicle like power steering, hydraulic brakes, so we have to find out the pressure of that system also. Then shock absorber system, that is related to the suspension system. Refrigerant system, that is related to the refrigeration, air conditioning of the vehicle. Then brake pressure in master and wheel brake system, that is another type of hydraulic reservoir pressure. And then the positive and vacuum pressure inside the fuel tank. So positive and vacuum pressure, whenever there is a fuel full of the full tank is there, the volume of the fuel is occupied with maximum volume is occupied with the fuel, but because of the emission, direct emission to the of the fuel due to the temperature inside the fuel tank, and there is a fumes of fuel. So we have to find out the pressure of that fuel tank if the size of the fuel tank is very high. Then gas sensor and concentration sensor, these are the sensors which are used to find out the concentration of any gas into the mixture. So it is important to find out the concentration of one material into the mixture to estimate the output with the ideal gas. The ideal concentration gas is important to monitor the temperature, pressure and emission quality of the vehicle. Then example of this type of sensors is a lambda oxygen sensor. By the help of gas sensor and concentration sensor, we can measure oxygen content in the exhaust gas, that is closed loop combustion system and catalytic converter monitoring. Then by examining the oxygen, we are checking the health of the combustion, whether the combustion is normal combustion or abnormal combustion. Then the carbon monoxide and nitrogen oxide content in the emission, then humidity in compressed air brake system. So by using the gas sensor and concentration sensor, we can identify these type of variables which are useful for us finding the health of the emission and the combustion of the vehicle. So that is all for today. Thank you very much.